Did you hear that? That reverb echoing finish at the end of the music. What if I told you that this wasn't on the Axel song, but actually I placed it inside Final Cut Pro. And this is what I call a very good editing when you want to stop the music and give a good impression.
We're in the Final Cut Pro interface and let's see how we can do this very easy effect. We have the music. We can dance a little bit if we want. And here where we want the end to happen, let's say that we want right here, I will select the audio clip. I'm making sure that this yellow skimming line is where I want the stop to appear. And then I will go here, as you can see, where we can have the retiming options, and I will select hold. Alternatively, I can hold Shift and H in my keyboard. Now we will go at the end of this hold with the B on our keyboard and we are gonna blade this and delete the rest of it. And now at the beginning of the final beat, again I will press B on my keyboard and I'm gonna blade this as well. Good so far? Good so far. Now we go into the effects, we will search for Cathedral. We will drag this and place it at the final clip. And then we go into the inspector panel and let's raise it to around 60. You can place it wherever you want. A little bit more is even better. So the result is gonna look like this. Did you hear that? So let's see without the effect. And with the cathedral effect. And of course, if we want to have a little bit more smooth ending, we will create a little bit of fade out, as you can see here from the fade handle. Lastly, as a bonus, one more idea that you can do, you can take this as well. You can press Option G to create a compound clip. And then you can have the option on your keyboard and click for it to duplicate it. And then go here to the retiming option and reverse clip. Then we will go where the beat, let me zoom in a little bit, where the beat starts. I will place it here. And also I will have an intro for that ending. So it's gonna sound like this.
This video's idea is coming from Javier Mercedes, who created a tutorial for Adobe Premiere on how to end with the reverb echo. And also, Javier is celebrating 100,000 subscribers. So, if you want to learn how you can do that in Adobe Premiere, I will have links in the description down below as well. When creating videos, one of the most important things is audio. Now, you learned how you can create the reverb at the end of the audio. If you don't know how to create the fade in and the fade out effect, then this video that is popping right now is going to be the best choice for you to continue watching after this one. So that was it. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you stayed until this time of this video and you haven't subscribed yet, go subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio and I will see you in the next video.